Good morning, children. So, in the previous class, we have finished with all the course which is coming this year. And there are some deleted chapters like Management of Natural Resources is deleted because it is not for the evaluation purpose. So, if you study it, but the questions will not come from it. And the sources of energy is also completely deleted. So whatever chapter were there included in the course which will, from which the questions will come, that is already been taught. Now I got two options. Either I teach those chapters which are remaining, which is of no use. So it is wastage of time. So it's better that we revise chapter 6 which I taught from home, and many of you must have not seen those videos. So let us take the revision of chapter 6. The name of the chapter is Life Processes. The name of the chapter is Life Processes. Now, what is meant by the term life processes? We are living beings, and you have seen so many living beings around you. Okay? You must have seen human beings, dogs, cats, rats, spiders, mosquitoes, flies, so many birds, variety of birds are there. Then so many reptiles, creepers and all. They all are living beings. First of all, the question is, what makes you to say that they are living beings? Because you see them moving? No, that's not necessary, because the plants are not moving. Then they got sensory organs. There are many of them have got sensory organs, but we have not heard any plant responding to our voice or to other type of responses. Or even if they are responding, they are so slow that we cannot notice. But of course, their responses are definitely there. And then what makes us to say that they are living? So all the living beings have some important characteristics. What are those characteristics? Let us look on that all the living beings have respiration. Now respiration doesn't mean that intake of air and giving out of carbon dioxide, or taking in of oxygen, giving out of carbon dioxide, which we have studied in the earlier classes. That is a foolish definition, which we will improve in this year. Now next classes, whenever I teach, or the you see through the videos which is already there on the net. Secondly, that is they have nutrition, that is they take some type of nutrients into their body. Third is locomotion, movement. Okay? It's not necessary that they move, but there are particles which are moving within their body, that type of things which are moving inside the body, that is called transport. And the fourth one is excretion, that is the elimination of waste. These four things are always going on, and they are collectively known as life processes. Besides this, movement and locomotion is important feature of all the living beings. They show certain type of movement, though they may not be locomoting. Not all the organisms are moving from one place to another place, but they are having certain type of movement. Then they have got response to stimuli. Then they have got growth and development. That all the living beings which are born, that is when they are newly formed, they are always small, and then later on they attain their normal size. And some grow continuously throughout their life, and there are some which grow to a certain limitation. Then development is there, that is the formation of new tissue, organ systems and all. So when we were born to ready-made chalon, to pure band karke aaye, but that is like if you see about the other organisms, the body is always from a single cell organism, that is called a single cell, that is called zygote. And the single cell, that is one cell that divide number of times and forming million and trillions of cells. And these cells then arrange themselves into organs, into tissues, and tissue into organ, and organ into system. And that is how the various type of systems are formed. So each of our body part which we are saying having the different type of tissue, which got epithelial tissue, then we got muscular tissue, then we got sensory tissue, and we got connective tissue and all, and they are forming them. Okay, so this is the part of a process called development. Then all the living beings, they have an ability to show reproduction even, but not necessarily that they all will reproduce and all the time reproduce. There is a certain time for reproduction, and there is certain maturity for reproduction, and certain period for reproduction before that and after that they do not have the reproduction. Not all the living beings reproduce, but whenever reproduction is there, that is shown by only living beings. Then we also seen that the living beings have definite molecular structure, different body structure, different organization, and even definite lifespan. That is, all the living being which have come on this earth will definitely die one day or other. Now death, when it appears, it may appear before the birth or soon after the birth or during the course of growth and during the course of maturity and during the course of old age, or death can appear, but all the living beings have to follow this system. That is, they are born, they are mature, they get old, and they die if it is a natural process. Otherwise, the death can occur anytime. So these are some of the important characteristics of all the living beings. Out of these, the four processes, that is the nutrition, respiration, transport and excretion, are those processes which are all the time going on in your body. I am having nutrition at this time, I am excreting even some material, I am having all the movement also in my body, and at the same time I am even having respiration. So respiration is quite prominent. Everyone sees, sir, aap breathe kar rahe ho, but that breathing and respiration are two different things. So that all things we will study in this chapter. So I will not teach you the beginning, that is the preface of the chapter. We shall start with nutrition. So what is meant by the term nutrition? Nutrition means that intake of nutrients and then utilization. Every living organ, in order to live, requires certain type of basic molecules, and these molecules will serve two most important functions. First of all, they will make their body, and secondly, they will give energy. Okay, so my body is, say for example, is made up of proteins, calcium, magnesium, phosphorus, and is there are the proteins, carbohydrates, vitamins, hormones. There are so many different type of things are required, and these things we cannot create, we cannot make in our body. So that is why we require it from the external source. And what are the external sources? They are through the body of some other organs. So we are always eating some other organs' body, may it be plant, may it be animal, may it be some other things. Okay. So we are getting all, we are deriving them indirectly from plants, maybe by the course of some other organs. So that all things which we are getting from some other organs in order to satisfy our basic needs are called nutrition. They may be making or building our body, or they may be used in maintaining our body, they may be used for repair of our body, they may be used for replacement of the lost thing, they may be used for regeneration, they may be used for reproduction. And a sufficient there are several type of nutrient molecules like carbohydrates, proteins and fat. They have got energy in their molecules, and that is the chemical energy, and this chemical energy is converted in our body's own requirement. So whatever type of activity we perform, for that energy is ultimately coming from food or nutrients. Okay, now there are two categories of organisms on the basis of nutrition. There are a category of organisms which can make nutrient of their own. They just require nutrient molecules, and the basic molecule and the other molecule they produce their own. They are called autotrophs. So the word auto means self, troph means nutrients. Autotroph and the second one are called heterotroph. Hetero means others, and troph means nutrient, that is those which derive their nutrient from some other organs. Okay, the autotrophs are of two types, that is the photoautotroph, that is those organs which prepare their food in the presence of light, using light energy. The photoautotrophs are those organs which are preparing their food using light. Photo means light. Autotroph we already written. And the second one are chemoautotroph. Chemoautotroph are those microorganisms, they are definitely only microorganisms. So they are those microorganisms which prepare their food or their molecules using the energy derived from the oxidation of inorganic substances. Oxidation of inorganic substances, that is chemicals. Don't simply go that they produce their food by using chemicals. Everything is chemical. You are chemical, I am chemical, or every part of our body is chemical. This chalk which I am holding is also a chemical, gypsum. Okay, the food which we are eating is also a bunch of chemicals. They may have certain type of carbohydrate, proteins and fats, and even ghee lagaya to tel bhi aur ghee aur fats ke form honge. There are some minerals there, DNA is there, there are RNA is there, there are so many different type of molecules are there everywhere. Let these type of definition be kept for those people who are foolish, they never been to school, and they say hamare product mein koi chemical nahi hai. है ना, बहुत सारे बोलते हैं ऐसे आकर कि इट इज केमिकल फ्री. देर इज नथिंग विच इज केमिकल फ्री. इवन अ ग्लास ऑफ वाटर विच आर हैविंग केमिकल, बिकॉज ग्लास इटसेल्फ इज केमिकल, H2O, यू आर स्टडीड इन द स्मॉलर ग्लासेस. हेटरोट्रॉप्स आर दोज हॉर्मोन्स विच कैन नॉट मेक देयर ओन फूड एंड दे आर डिपेंडिंग ऑन अदर हॉर्मोन फॉर देयर फूड पर्पस. हेटरोट्रॉप्स. नाउ हेटरोट्रॉप्स आर फर्दर डिवाइडेड इनटू टू, दैट इज होलोजाइक एंड दैट इज सेप्टोजाइक. Holozoic are those organs which is taking the food in the solid form. We can even write third one into the parent cell. Holozoic are those which are taking their food in the form of solid, and they are breaking them in their body. That is, the process of digestion is taking place inside the body. So when the process of digestion is taking place inside the body, they are called holozoic. Holozoic, when they are depending on the type of food they are taking, if they are getting their plant from the, their food from the plants, so then they are called carnivore. If they are getting their food from only animals, they are called carnivore. And if they are getting their food from plant as well as animal, they are called omnivore. Okay, now that is, herbivores are only those organs which derive their food only and only from the plant products. So you cannot call yourself as an omnivore or herbivore. We all are, human beings are omnivore, because we are getting several food from the animals, may it be in the form of milk or curd or all the milk made substances or honey and others that we are getting from the animals. So we will be omnivore because we are getting some of our food from the plants and some of our food from animals, whereas those also which are eating they are getting their food only and only from the plants, they are herbivores. Hello. Carnivores are those which are getting their food only and only from animals. That is, they are not eating anything else. They will always eat flesh of the other organs, like lion or tiger. You cannot see any lion and tiger eating chapatis or rice or anything else. They will be simply killing some other organs. Okay. Now carnivore again are two types, that is the predators which kills and eats, and the scavengers which feed on the body of other organs. Scavengers. Again, saprozoic are those organs which are digesting their food outside their body. They are those simplest organs. They do not have any what you call it, digestive system or any digestive gland in their body. So they will be secreting their digestive juices onto the dead bodies or other substances which are organic substances which cannot protect themselves. And the food will be digested, that is the organic substances will be digested, and the digested nutrients will be taken in their body. Since the digestion is taking place in the open, in the air, hence they cause rottening. Sapros means rottening. Rottening means a foul smell which is caused because of the chemical process which are taking place in the exterior. Okay, so saprozoic include all the microorganisms and a certain type of fungi, mushrooms and other organisms which are actually digesting the dead organic substances, maybe the leaves of the fallen from the plants or the fruits or the body of animal, dead animals, body, etc., etc. Okay, the parasite on the other hand are those organisms which are deriving their food from the living host. Okay, and that is already pre-digested, so they do not require them to be digesting, and these substances are taken into their body either by some sucking or some other mechanism, whatever may be the thing. Okay, so these are the three different type of heterotrophs. Autotrophs I already talked. Okay, now we shall consider first, that is the proto-autotrophs. Okay, so this is proto-autotrophs. The photo means light. And autotrophs means that is those organs which can prepare food their own. Okay, don't say that they are producing food. They are producing food for their own. They are producing food for all entire living beings. You and me could not have survived if autotrophs are not made protein, carbohydrate, fat, DNA, RNA. Because we cannot make DNA, we cannot make RNA, we cannot make protein, we cannot make carbohydrate, we cannot make any of the organic molecule. We can simply change it from one form to another. That is the only thing, that is we can derive the one molecule from other molecule, but we cannot make them. And making is actually done by the phototrophs, that is the plants. Okay, so the plants are making organic molecule for entire living beings, not only for their survival, not only for making their body, not only for their reproduction, regeneration, replacement and growth and development, but also for providing energy. The energy which we get from our food is ultimately stored by the plants which they have got from the sunlight. Okay, so phototrophs are required for different type of things. They are light, then they got carbon dioxide, then they got water, and they got chloroplast. CHLO, chloroplast. Okay, so these are the things which they require. Light can be any light. Kaunsa light? That is visible light. Visible light kaunsa? That is the light which you can see. Anything which you can see is in the visible light, and the visible light has wavelength which is varying from VIBGYOR. All these are visible light. Out of that, the maximum photosynthesis takes place at this two end, minimum photosynthesis takes place at this end. Okay, but all the visible lights are used in photosynthesis. Maximum amount is used in the red light. Okay. Now, what can be the source of light? The source of the light can be sunlight, or it can be moonlight, or even in the tube light, or even the candle light. Okay? You have got number of plants which you are keeping inside the house only. You have never put them out or never exposed to the sunlight. Those are the plants which are using. They are surviving the diffused light, or they are using the light which are they getting from the bulb or tube lights. Okay, there are some plants which we have kept in aquarium, and fishes and others are there, and they are also carrying out, they are also surviving, so they are making their photosynthesis using the light from the tube lights on. Okay, the second is carbon dioxide. What is the source of carbon dioxide? For the aquatic plant, it is the carbon dioxide which is found dissolved in the water, and for a land plant, the carbon dioxide which is found in the air. In air, the carbon dioxide is somewhere around 0.03%. And in the water, it is up to 2 to 3%. Okay, the carbon dioxide is taken into the leaf through a small pore between the leaves. They are called stomata, which we have studied in class 9. And the stomata open during daytime, and the carbon dioxide is let in, and carbon oxygen is given out. At the same time, transpirational loss of water is also there. Okay, and the aquatic plant also, their carbon dioxide diffuses into their leaf through the opening of this, because the rest of the part is actually covered by cuticle, which is waterproof. Okay, so carbon dioxide, now there are some plant exercise. Just now I said the stomata is actually leading even for the transpiration. So there are some plants which are growing in the desert area, that is in those places where the temperature is very high and the water is availability is very low. In such case, the carbon dioxide they actually store during the night, because if during daytime they open the stomata just to take the carbon dioxide in, then that carbon dioxide, that opening of the stomata can cause transpirational loss of water, and they may die, because whatever amount of water was available to them, that all would be dried up. So the stomata, they have to keep open only during night, and as during night the transpiration rate is very very minimized, and the carbon dioxide which they take in, that is stored in some chemicals and kept, and during daytime these chemicals are broken and the carbon dioxide is released, which will be available for the photosynthesis. Third is water. The ultimate source of water is soil. So from the soil, the water reaches to each and every cell, even in the green plastid, that is chloroplast. Okay, so that is not a problem. And the fourth one is the green color pigment, which is found in all the plants, because of which the plants appear green. Now, it hardly matters that there are some plants, the leaves are not green, but I can say the large number of plants which are growing in front of me, their leaves are purplish red. There are some plants in which the leaves are yellow. There are some plants in which the leaves are some other color. But whatever may be. The chlorophyll is always present. The chloroplast is actually green color plastic in which the chlorophyll is there. Chlorophyll can be. Chlorophyll can be of 5 type, A, B, C, D and E. The main chlorophyll is chlorophyll A, which is used in photosynthesis. Second highest is chlorophyll B. The others are there. And besides that, there are other pigments, xanthophylls, which are reddish in color, reddish purple, and the carotenoids are there. And their combination actually give the color to the leaf. So whatever, if it is appearing reddish in color, that means it has got more of keratin and then the chlorophyll. But there, that doesn't mean that it doesn't have chlorophyll. Chlorophyll is definitely there, and it is the chlorophyll A which only is used for photosynthesis to the maximum. Other pigments are just absorbing light and passing it to chlorophyll A. Okay, so these are the basic contents which are required for the process of photosynthesis. Now photosynthesis process, the process of photosynthesis completes in 3 steps. The process of photosynthesis completes in 3 steps. What are the 3 steps? First is the collection of all the required things. Okay? That is harvesting of light energy and absorption of water and CO2. These are the raw materials which are required in photosynthesis. Second is splitting of water into hydrogen and oxygen, and this hydrogen will be used for reduction of carbon dioxide, and oxygen will be given out. And the third one is the reduction of CO2 into, primarily it is done into glucose, which is later on changed into something else as and when whatever required. So the very first thing is that is the harvesting of light. Where the harvesting of light is done, it is done by the chlorophyll. Okay, and water is absorbed from the roots and reached to the leaves by xylem. And carbon dioxide is absorbed by the entered into the leaves through stomata. So that is not a problem. The biggest problem is splitting of water. Splitting of water is such a process which is chemically done in the plants in the presence of chlorophyll and sunlight. Okay? Interestingly, it is such a complicated process. If we had to do it in the laboratory, we can only do it by electricity, and we call it electrolysis of water, which you have studied in the in your chapter 1 or chapter 2, that is acid base or chapter 1, you have studied that the water can split into hydrogen and oxygen by passing electricity. Okay, but the plant doesn't have electricity. Then how plant to convert the water into hydrogen and oxygen? They have got a very specific process called the splitting or photolysis of water. Photolysis is actually done in presence of light in chlorophyll. As the name indicates, photo means light and lysis means breakdown. That is the breakdown of water in presence of light. Okay? So how it is done? We have to take 4 molecules of water, say for example, just for the balancing I am taking 4 molecules. So 4 molecules of water will change into 4 OH and 4 H ions. The 4 OH will change into 2 molecules of water and 1 molecule of oxygen. The oxygen will be given out as a waste, and the water will be reused here. And the hydrogen ion which are there, they will be absorbed by a special kind of molecule called NADP, which will change into NADPH2. Okay, NADPH2. This is the molecule. Okay, now I will tell you one important thing, that is the hydrogen ion is so vigorously active, you cannot simply leave it out, then it will react with something else. So immediately hydrogen ion which is formed is collected by the NADP, and NADP reduces into NADPH2. So this is the second process called splitting of water, which is done in the presence of light in the chlorophyll. And the third process is, that is the reduction. How is reduction done?
Very simple.
How is the reduction done? That is 6 molecules of carbon dioxide plus 12 molecules of water. I am taking water instead of hydrogen. So, because this is actually coming from water. So, 12 molecules of hydrogen plus 6 molecules of carbon dioxide.
I already did it. Sorry, children.
So 6 molecules of carbon dioxide is reduced by hydrogen, which is derived hydrogen ion, which are taken from the or which are removed from the 12 molecules of water in presence of light. And where the process is taking place? In chlorophyll. And it will give 1 molecule of glucose plus 6 molecule of water plus 6 molecule of oxygen. So this water will come again here and can be reused. Okay. So 6 molecule of carbon dioxide can be reduced by the hydrogen of water and change into glucose. The molecular formula of glucose is C6H12O6. Okay. So 6 carbon. 12 hydrogen, that will be 4. 6 here and 6 udhar chalega yahan. Okay. And oxygen kitna hai? That is 6 to the 12. 12 plus 6 and baki itna. So this is how the formation of glucose takes place. Now interestingly, you know that the plant is producing glucose in photosynthesis. That doesn't mean that plant require only glucose. Plant require many different type of molecules, maybe proteins, DNA, RNA, carbohydrates, hormones, vitamins. All these are organic molecules and all these are ultimately made by the plants. Okay? So the first molecule which is made by the plant is glucose. Later on, the glucose will be changed into starch and stored, and the glucose is a ready source of energy. But if some type of protein, some type of phosphorus, some type of sulfur, some type of other molecules are added to it, so it changes into some other molecule, and this is how the plant produces all the possible type of molecules which are required by the living kingdom by deriving it from the glucose. And for that, plant require number of other minerals, maybe calcium, magnesium, sulfur, phosphorus, iodine, bromine, zinc. You have studied macro and micromolecules in class 9. All those molecules are also derived ultimately from the soil and will reach to the leaves, and then these molecules are reacted with the glucose in many different combinations, and that will be used in protein making proteins, amino acid, fatty acid, DNA, RNA and all. And all the other living beings are simply depending on these molecules. So that's all for today, children. We have studied the basic processes which are taking place in the living being. They are called life processes, and other the processes which are there. Other processes may be shown and may not be shown. It is not necessary that every living being has to show reproduction, but every living being has to show respiration. It is not necessary that every living organism will show response to the stimuli. There are so many which are in coma. You just uthao, patko, khencho, pincho bao, sui pijao, they will not be responding. There are many people who are undergoing surgery, and we are simply giving them some injection. And then after that, you can just cut their body, they don't even come to know. But they are still living. But you cannot stop one's respiration even for a minute or even for 10 seconds. He will definitely die. Now that doesn't mean you think that sir, मैं तो 10 सेकंड तक तो क्या 3 मिनट तक सांस रोक के बैठ सकता हूँ. सांस रोकना is not, सांस is breathing. Respiration is internal process. Breathing is external process. So all those things we'll study in the coming chapter, coming periods. That's all, children. Thank you. Good day. Bye.